I'm going to show you the answer to this by doing it in a spreadsheet. You could do all of these calculations without any technology, and if you did that, that's really great. It's always really good practice to calculate things without using any technology. But just for the purposes of figuring out the standard deviation, technology can really speed along this process. So I'm not going to use any shortcuts here. I'm going to do it exactly as we would if we didn't have technology. So first, we need to take the average of all of these. So we're going to sum them up. So we're taking the sum of all of these. I could also just write equals A1 plus A2 plus A3 all the way to A10. And we'd get the same thing. But why would we do that if we can simply write this? Now, to take the average, all we do is divide by the number of values, which is 10. So that's just going to be 51,511.1. Alternatively, the nice thing about technology is we can just do this. Take the sum and divide by the total number. Do it all in one step. So now we have the average. Now we're going to subtract the average from each one of these values. Not the opposite, where we subtract each of these values from the mean. That's an important distinction. In this case, it doesn't matter as much, but in other statistical concepts, that's an important distinction to make. So we'll write equals A1 minus the mean. So we're subtracting the mean from each of these values. Now we could just do the same thing here and write equals A2 minus the mean, but that would be tedious. We can just drag this down. When you do that, remember that there has to be a little plus sign there. That means you're successfully dragging it down. If you went like this, it won't do anything. It'll just highlight the boxes. So here we have the deviations from the mean. Here in the next column, we're going to square each deviation. Equals B1 squared. And again, we're going to drag it down. So we have the squared deviations for each of these values. Now remember that the variance is the average squared deviation. So we could just write average of C1 to C10, but I want to make sure we go through all the other steps in between. So let's again practice calculating the average, just for clarity's sake. So the variance then would be the sum of C1 to C10. Remember, that's how you start out taking the average and then divide by 10. So here's the variance, and then the standard deviation is simply the square root of the variance. So we'll write equals SQRT, that's the shortcut for square root, and then we can just say C13. So we know that the standard deviation is 6,557.16 approximately. Now I want to point out something really important before we finish this solution video. Here I simply said equals square root of this cell, C13. Whereas here, I wrote out the whole average. The reason for that is because, say I had put the cell here, A13. Then, when we drag it down, we don't get the right deviations. And we can double-click on it and see what it did. Here, it took A4 minus A16. Whereas here, it took A1 minus A13, which is what we wanted. But we want it to always stay A13. Which is why we have to make sure this is a constant. And the way to make sure it's a constant is by just writing it. Notice also that all of these values changed when these values changed, because all these values are dependent on these values. So when we change it back, we should again get the correct standard deviation.